ball so hard, do you know what it be costing? Niggas wanna call me Spalding. When I'm black, I never stop. From the bottom to the top, and I be doing it often. Splitting everything like a nigga divorcing. Niggas know they dead, put them all in the coffin. Why, yo, why, nigga, for nigga, why, yeah? You think it was confetti, all this bread I be tossing. Throwback word, nigga be flossing. When I'm giving you the heat, you know a nigga be scorching. Y'all be reminding me of pigs and swine. Turn them niggas into animal shortening. Ding, ding, A lot of motherfuckers, they be acting like they really important. Until I come and then I kill another recording. Don't you know I'm counting money every morning?
What up, y'all? It's your nigga Dub C, a.k.a. Skip Skip, the motherfucking Barracuda. And you are now on Reach Around Radio. Tuned the fuck in. Stay tuned in. Turn it up, turn it up. Bang! Mia!
Mia!
Yo. We're back. It's Reach Around Radio.
It's my shit.
That's your shit, CJ?
It's Three Pump Monk in the house.
That's crazy. Lil Red Rhino. Michael Jordan Jackson.
Rick James, bitch.
It is Halloween. Happy Halloween.
Yes,
all
is.
The yes. Ghosts and goblins out there.
Yes, and we have a caller. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from? Damn.
Shoot him.
What the?
Always.
DJ.
The number is 323.
Nice. DJ not paying attention.
247-7443. Put your mask on, pimp.
Leave him alone.
Punk.
Doing his job. Okay.
I got a joke. What's up? Why witches don't mess with ghosts?
I don't know why.
Because they have Halloweenies. Get it? Halloween, Halloweenies. My niece told me that. She said, please say this. You hear that, little girl?
There you go.
Kill yourself, little girl.
Shooting these motherfuckers.
That sound can only mean one thing.
What's that?
It's time. For our game show.
Which one?
It's called Guess What Race. All right. And this week, we are going to start keeping tabs on who gets what one right. Okay?
Shit.
So behind me, we have a leaderboard. Guess
Speedy's,
What Race leaderboard.
Speedy's first.
We have Speedy
like
first.
That.
The POTUS in pink. TV in purple. RT in green.
He's not even here.
Teal. He's in teal.
All right. So whatever.
So who's going to play for him?
Nobody.
Let's get Tiffany.
Somebody got to play for him.
No, Tiffany got market.
Well, we just
come
on. It's just normally
this is the way to get here.
Here we go. We're gonna start keeping track now. Okay, she can go market.
Yeah, go on. Stand over here.
Yeah, get
she
over
can
here.
Be our marker.
Let them see.
There you go.
Oh my goodness.
Come on, Vanna Black. Vanna Titties.
Okay.
Cleavage.
I'm ready.
First story.
Tiffy having her things out.
Let's set this off. Get this shit popping.
How old are you, Tiff?
Speedy.
Oh, I'm sorry. Stay focused, Speedy. Focus, focus.
Focus, nigga. All right. A man.
I'm a monk. I ain't had
Hey, shut up. A man set his girlfriend on fire as he drove his pickup truck on the freeway after the two argued about a Sprint cell phone bill and accusations of cheating. Mm. He grabbed a gasoline can, doused his honey, and lit her on fire. Mm. She managed to undo her seatbelt, open the passenger side door, and jump out of the moving truck without being struck by other vehicles.
Okay.
The driver kept right on going until smashing into a slow-moving garbage truck. He was not injured, but the unidentified woman he torched, certainly was, suffering burns and other injuries.
Well, we know she's black now.
Remarkably, she's out of the hospital. The man was sentenced Wednesday to 15 years in state prison.
Punk.
Wow. Guess what race?
Only 15.
POTUS. What do you say?
I'm going to say Latino on this one.
Latino. Put her down for... Oh, wait, not yet. Okay. Yeah. Speedy.
Calm down, Mike.
Well, there's some clues in here. Truck.
I can relate to being burnt.
Truck, arguing over phone bill, and who they fucking. So I'm going to go with Colonizer.
Colonizer for Speedy. Rick James, bitch, who do you say?
I'm going to go with Indonesianese.
Indonesianese.
Located where?
In Indonesia.
There you
bitch.
Go.
All
right. Everybody locked in.
Locked and loaded.
Okay, POTUS, you said Latino?
Yes.
You said white?
White. Indonesianese.
All right. The man who liked to barbecue, the man who liked his barbecue to go was a 39-year-old Mexican man named Constantino Monterosas Gomez.
I got POTUS.
Hey, POTUS, guess one. Mark me down.
One for POTUS.
Oh, shit.
Shout out to Structure.
Got those Karl Malone arms.
All right. Next story.
You got to come into frame, baby girl. Come into frame. Yeah, there you go.
You going to play the game and direct the game, too?
Okay, next up. A stingy drug dealer led to a shooting and killing of one of his weed customers. According to
County Bong, what happened?
According to police, the suspect was a traveling weed salesman dropping off some pot at the victim's house. A man approached the dealer's car for his special weed delivery and expected to receive $5 change for his payment. The dealer did not want to give back the $5 change, which led to an argument causing the unsatisfied customer punching the dealer in the face. The dealer then pulled out his gun and shot his customer, immediately killing him.
Oh my God.
The shooter has been charged with one count of second-degree murder. Mm. Guess what race? POTUS. I expect big things from you.
I'm going to have to say black on this one.
Black man. She's going with the coons.
Because niggas will sweat $5.
Shamey.
Yeah.
Speedy, what say you?
Leroy Jenkins.
Black man. Negro. TDP.
I'm going to go with Filipinonese.
Filipinos. They like their weed too. Don't get it twisted. All right. So we got black Filipino.
Black Filipino.
All right. Tiffany, get ready. The dummy drug dealer that didn't have change for a 10 was a 29-year-old black man named Joaquin Donnell Hahn.
Joaquin. Two for two.
There you go.
Two-piece chicken. Two.
Give me one, baby. Give her one.
POTUS
give
got
me
one and Speedy got one.
Yeah. Just give me a Janet. Point for my outfits, bitch.
All right. POTUS is winning.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
It ain't gonna happen.
So imagine you've just moved out to a new town. Before you spend time unpacking or checking out local amenities, your first priority is to get stoned. But you don't grow weed yourself, and you're miles away from your dealer. Panic? What do? If this is your if you're this genius, then you'll come to the most obvious conclusion. Get on Craigslist and see who can help out. The pothead posted that she was new in town and looking for Mary Jane. Well, police responded, and they arranged to meet her in a parking lot and arrested her for criminal solicitation. Guess what, race? POTUS, once again, this is all you.
I'm going to go with white on this one.
Whites?
Yes.
Okay. Whites. Hmm. Craigslist. Speedy.
Craigslist, white. Yeah. I'm going to go with Suzanne Brady.
Brady. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Although you've had an associate family member did something similar. But anyway.
Yeah. Didn't you?
Maybe that was him.
Baby mama tried to sell OxyContin online. Oh, my bad. Not to put you on blast. TDP.
That was an exclusive.
Oh, check the blog. TDP. I'm sorry, Donald, was that your mother? One of the other ones? All right. TDP?
Mozambicanese.
Located where?
Interesting.
In Africa.
All right. So.
Anything else, Pop?
Whites? Whites?
Yes.
African.
Mozambicanese.
The 30-year-old pot fiend was a black woman named.
I got it right.
Amika Dave.
Amika? What the hell is wrong with you, girl?
Mark one down for TDP.
Bitch.
All right.
Amika.
Oh, actually, you do have five. Okay. Authorities in Texas say a 53-year-old convicted sex offender recently dropped dead while attempting to rape a 77-year-old woman inside her home.
Give me some.
The suspect rode his bike about 2 miles from his home to the elderly victim's house. Once there, he allegedly entered the home through a screen door and confronted her with a pocket knife.
Hey,
he told her he would not hurt her and he was going to have sex with her.
And they gonna rape that nigga.
Hysterical.
The suspect was not successful in his attempt to rape the elderly woman, although he did assault her. He never had sex with her. He rubbed her private areas and was kissing her. During the alleged assault, police say that the 5'7" tall, 230-pound suspect complained of severe chest pains.
Mm.
He told her, listen here, I'm going to have to take a rest. So he laid down on his side and took a little rest. Then he got back up and started doing the same thing again. The
police were there.
A few minutes later, he stopped up again and said, I have to rest again. But then he laid down and he expired and died.
Wow.
So he died while trying to rape a woman. Guess what race? POTUS, you're on fire. What's it going to be?
How much time did he get?
I'm going to say white on this one.
Sounds like a white thing.
Yeah.
European.
Take a break.
Speedy, have you ever had old coochie?
Well, when I was 25, yeah.
Okay.
She was 50.
Speedy?
What is old coochie, Speedy?
Rent. Let's move on.
Wow, okay.
I got my whole apartment furnished. Let's move on. I'm going to go... Javier Sanchez.
Latino. Mm-hmm. Okay. TDP.
I'm going to go with Norwegianese.
Think they'd sacrifice their life to rape somebody?
Norwegianese.
Alrighty, everybody's locked in. All right. The man who could not beat the pussy up was a 53-year-old Latino man named Isabel Chabelo Gutierrez.
Give me one.
Speedy is Spanish.
You know what gave it away?
What?
Showed up on a bike.
Mm-hmm. Oh, damn.
It's 5'3".
Yeah.
Okay, last story. Last story. POTUS and Speedy, surprisingly, neck and neck.
Mm.
Titty and titty.
You guys have things, something in common this week.
He said titty and titty, so he admits he has tits. Yeah.
Release the hounds.
Okay. This one's interesting here, okay? Mm-hmm. Three women have been accused of sex attacks on male hitchhikers, allegedly to steal their semen for use in ritual practices. The gang appeared to face charges of 17 counts of aggravated indecent assault. The women were arrested by police, were found with 33 condoms containing semen.
I'll take
that. Police believe the arrest is a break in a string of sex attacks over the past 2 years by women targeting male hitchhikers. According to police officials, 17 men have been positively identified. They have positively identified the women as having raped them. Most of the men said the women would offer a drink either laced with something to tranquilize them or were forced at gunpoint.
Ooh.
Guess what?
On all four?
Race. The women are a gang and they're the same nationality. Guess what race?
I want to guess what freeway.
That's a tough one.
Yeah,
I'm gonna go with Latina on this one.
Y'all blame the Latins for everything.
Well, I say that because one, it's a gang.
Wow.
And two, they might be into some ritualistic stuff.
With some chicken bones?
Yeah.
Okay. I got your peppers. So
peppers.
Chicken and yellow rice. Okay, Speedy.
That was a hard one.
Ain't it?
I'm going to go with Susie Chapstick.
That's the same thing she said.
I'm going with Susie Chapstick.
White girl, you think white women would rape men in a gang and put the semen in the condoms and then get busted? Okay. You never know. You never know, Speedy. TDP.
Oh my God, you said that. Did you read the story? Yes.
I'm going to go with Czech Republic knees.
Czech Republic.
Yes.
They are shiesty. Mm. And they do have a taste for the semen. All righty. This one's disturbing to me.
Oh, please don't say it.
The three women who were sperm banded.
Hmm?
Let me try that again. The three women who were sperm banded.
Oh, the B was silent.
Were
the D
Zimbabweans?
Oh, I got it right.
From Africa, TDP with black.
Oh my God!
Three African women. They use it in rituals. So yes.
Wow.
Give me a point.
Wow.
He said, "Give me a point."
It is
bitch.
Tied up,
bitch.
Guess what race is tied up to a piece?
Wow.
This has been the Halloween edition of
Guess what race.
So we're going to take a quick break. You're listening to Reach Around Radio on LATalkLive.com. Hit us on the phones, 323-247-7443.
What freeway was that again?
Meow.